Hello everyone and welcome back to the Perfect French with Dylan. Today we are going to learn when to use the subjonctif. So yesterday we saw how to conjugate a verb in the subjonctif. Today we are going to see when to use it. On the book we are going from page 235 to 247. This lesson is going to be a little bit long. Feel free to go from one chapter to another. All the chapters in this video have timings. But first, I would like to thank Lingoda for sponsoring this video. If you've never heard of Lingoda, Lingoda is the number one online language school. It was founded in 2013 in Germany, and so far, Lingoda helped 70,000 students with their language journey. With Lingoda, you can learn French, English, business English, German, and Spanish. But today, I want to talk to you about something that I think is an incredible opportunity for your French. The Lingoda Language Sprint, and especially the Super Sprint. So with the Super Sprint, you are going to attend 30 classes a month for 3 months, so 90 classes in total. And the greatest thing about it is that at the end, if you attend all the classes, you get 100% cash back. So the sprint doesn't cost you anything. But to take advantage of the 100% cashback, you have to register before June 24th. If you register after, you can still do the Super Sprint, but you will get 50% of your cashback if you attend all the classes. If you think that 30 classes a month for 3 months is too much for you, you can try to do the Sprint. The Sprint is 15 lessons a month for 3 months as well. For this one, you can get 50% cashback if you attend all the lessons. For both of them, you can sign up until July 16 and the sprint starts on August 2nd. Personally, I think that Lingoda is great because it has flexible hours. You can find classes 24/7 no matter where you live. All their teachers are qualified native speaking teachers and they come from all around the world. And finally, my favorite thing about Lingoda is that all the classes are in small group only. Each class is 60 minutes and has around 2 to 3 students, maximum 5. So if you want to register for one of the sprints, you will have to make a deposit of €49 or $59. The sprint is going to be paid once a month for 3 months. So if you are ready to take your French to the next level, you can sign up for one of the sprints with my link in the description box and use the code FAST40 for a discount of €20 on the deposit. Also, don't forget to check out their frequently asked questions, and you can also check out their Instagram to see student success stories on their story highlights at Lingoda Official. Once again, thank you to Lingoda for sponsoring this video. Now let's start the lesson about the subjonctif. So when to use the subjonctif. The subjonctif, like I said yesterday, is always going to be used after que, mostly in subordinate clause and indicate a wish, a regret, an emotion, an opinion, or a doubt. We are going to see that more in details. But first, what is a subordinate clause? Subordinate clause is the part of the sentence after que. So we have the main clause, then we have que, then we have the subordinate clause. Let's see one sentence. Je veux que ce problème soit réglé. Je veux que ce problème soit réglé. So, je veux is the main clause. Que ce problème soit réglé. Ce problème soit réglé is the subordinate clause. And soit réglé is the subjonctif. I want this problem to be solved. And as you can see, que is not always translated in English. So when I'm going to talk to you today about all the different cases we are going to find a subjonctif, when I list you all the verbs and everything, obviously there will always be a que. I will translate it to that, but it's not always going to be translated as that in the sentence. In English, we don't always translate que. So you know that I absolutely love finding little tips and tricks for you to remember easily. And today I have something very similar than Dr. and Mrs. van der Tremp with the passé composé avec être, if you remember. Today, for the subjonctif, I have weirdo. So I'm not calling you a weirdo, I'm just saying that each letter is going to stand for a situation when we use the subjonctif. So W stands for wish. E stands for emotion. I stands for impersonal expression. R stands for regret and recommendation. D stands for doubts. And O stands for opinion. Weirdo. There's a little bit more than that. We have a few more points that we are going to see today, but that's a good way to start. Also on the book, the subjonctive is a whole chapter. But if you need another guide, something more in detail about the subjonctive, with more exercises, with more examples, I would be more than happy to make one when I have time. So just let me know in the comment section if you would like one. I can add that to my very long list of things to do. Okay, let's start by when we use the subjonctive to express a wish. I'm going to give you a few verbs that I usually follow by the subjonctive. You have more in the book. I can't really put everything that there is in the book in this lesson. So make sure to read everything that's in the book to really know everything about it. So, attendre que, to wait that. Avoir envie que, to want that. Insister pour que, be careful with the pour, we have to add the pour. Insister pour que, to insist that. Demander que, to ask that. J'insiste pour qu'elle reçoive un cadeau aussi. J'insiste pour qu'elle reçoive un cadeau aussi. I insist that she gets a gift as well. J'insiste pour is the main clause. Then we have que. And then we have elle reçoive un cadeau aussi. So that's the subordinate clause. So the subjonctive is in the subordinate clause. Reçoive is the verb recevoir. But when you think about a wish, usually you will say I hope that. Well, with I hope, with hope, we don't use the subjonctive. Even with que. Let's see. J'espère que tu seras là. J'espère que tu seras là. I hope you will be there. So here, this is not the subjonctive, this is the indicative. First exercise of the day, 11.5. The second one of weirdo is the E, so to express an emotion. And here we are mostly going to use it with être, adjective, and then que. So the adjective is going to agree in gender and number with the subject. I'm going to give you every time masculine and feminine, but it all depends on the subject, okay? So we have être content, contente, que, to be happy that. Être étonné, étonné, que, to be surprised that. Être soulagé, soulagé, que, to be relieved that. Être désolé, désolé, que, to be sorry that. Il était tellement content que tu sois venu. Il était tellement content que tu sois venu. Que tu sois venu, for me, the tu in this case is represent a feminine. He was so happy that you came. Another one. Je suis ravie que tu viennes ce week-end. Je suis ravie que tu viennes ce week-end. I'm delighted that you're coming this weekend. Sois venu is the verb venir be conjugated in the subjonctive passé. And the second one is the verb venir, subjonctive présent. So we saw a lot about the infinitive this week in the few last lessons. So the subjonctive is not used if the adjective is followed by an infinitive verb, obviously. Nous sommes désolés d'apprendre la nouvelle. Nous sommes désolés d'apprendre la nouvelle. Nous sommes désolés d'apprendre. There's no que, there's no subjonctive here. Second exercise, 11.6. Be careful that in this lesson and in this chapter, I give you a lot of examples when the subjonctive is not used. And I might have put a few of those in the exercises. Next point, with E, we have a personal expression used to talk about obligation. And most of them are going to be with il faut que. Il faut que is something that you're going to find a lot with the subjonctive. Most of them actually. Il faut que. You see, il faut que, 100% subjonctive. If there's no que, like we saw before, il faut plus verb, it's going to be the infinitive. So we have il faut que, il est important que, it's important that, il est préférable que, and il vaut mieux que, it's better that. So let's see two with il faut. Il faut que j'achète à manger. Il faut que j'achète à manger. I have to buy food. Il faut que tu prennes tes médicaments. Il faut que tu prennes tes médicaments. You have to take your medicine. One with il vaut mieux. Il vaut mieux que tu t'en ailles. Il vaut mieux que tu t'en ailles. It's better that you leave. So here it's s'en aller. S'en aller. To leave. When you feel comfortable with the subject, if you ever feel comfortable with the subject, you can do the exercises 11.7, 11.8. The next letter on weirdo is R. So, regret and recommendation. So, among the few verbs that we have recommander que, regretter que, suggérer que. So, this one is fairly easy actually. First sentence. Le ministre recommande que les vaccins soient distribués au plus vite. Le ministre recommande que les vaccins soient distribués au plus vite. Or, je regrette que tu l'apprennes de cette façon. Je regrette que tu l'apprennes de cette façon. I regret that you're learning this way. So this is probably the easiest point after il faut que. Il faut que is really easy. So it's going to be the subjonctif. And then we have regret recommendation, which are very easy to find in a sentence. Next exercise, 11.9. Weirdo, next point, D, to express a doubt. So we have, il est possible que, il est incroyable que, il semble que. And here, for il est can be replaced by c'est. So il est, you will find it more in books, more formal French. When c'est, you will find it more in informal French, spoken French. Let's see two sentences. Il semble que la tempête soit passée. Il semble que la tempête soit passée. Or, c'est impossible que tu aies raté ça. C'est impossible que tu aies raté ça. But here we have a little thing tricky that I would like to add before you do the exercises. When we look at the verb croire, penser, avoir l'impression, which can also express a doubt. All of them used in a positive sentence, in an affirmative sentence, are going to be used with the indicative. They're only going to be used in subjonctive with a negative sentence. So if we see croire, je crois qu'il sait cuisiner. Je crois qu'il sait cuisiner. I think he knows how to cook. So indicatif, but je ne crois pas qu'il sache cuisiner. Je ne crois pas qu'il sache cuisiner. I don't think he knows how to cook. Subjonctif. Avoir l'impression. J'ai l'impression qu'elle est déçue. J'ai l'impression qu'elle est déçue. Or, je n'ai pas l'impression qu'elle soit déçue. Je n'ai pas l'impression qu'elle soit déçue. Pensez. Je pense qu'il a du talent. Je pense qu'il a du talent. Or, je ne pense pas qu'il ait du talent. Je ne pense pas qu'il ait du talent. So, every time, positive affirmative sentence is going to be indicative. Negative sentence, or also actually, a question with the inversion, are going to be with the subjonctive. When you're good, you can do the exercises 11.10, 11.11. So, weirdo, the last one is opinions. So we have, il est bien que, il est dommage que, il est logique que, and il est rare que. In all cases, il est can be replaced by c'est once again. The gender of the adjective does not change after c'est or after il est. It's always going to be masculine singular. C'est dommage que vous ne puissiez pas venir. C'est dommage que vous ne puissiez pas venir. C'est logique qu'il ait gagné. C'est logique qu'il ait gagné. Makes sense, I won. Now you can practice with the exercise 11.12. Three more points to see, please stay with me. After some conjunction, we are going to have also the subjonctif, such as à condition que, afin que, jusqu'à ce que. So this one is a bit complicated, jusqu'à ce que. Don't try to overthink it. It's just one word, jusqu'à ce que. Then, pour que. This sentence makes me laugh every time I look at it because look at the size of the sentence in French and how many words there are in English. Let's see. Je suis d'accord à condition que tu te tiennes bien. Je suis d'accord à condition que tu te tiennes bien. I agree if you behave. Then we have. Elle utilise son vieux téléphone jusqu'à ce qu'elle reçoive le nouveau. Elle utilise son vieux téléphone jusqu'à ce qu'elle reçoive le nouveau. So you see, even though the conjunctions are very specific, they still all have que. There's no subjonctive without que. You can pause the video and do the exercise 11.13. So someone one day decided that the subjonctive was not hard enough, so he added the ne expletif. It's a ne that we are going to find sometimes in some conjunction after que. It doesn't have to do anything with negation. It doesn't really add anything to the sentence. We just use it to draw attention on the main clause. As a teacher, I would really like to have a word with the person who decided that.
That would be great.
But until then, let's see the conjunction. We have à moins que, ne. Avant que, ne. De crainte que, ne. De peur que, ne. Sans que, ne. Let's see the sentence. You're going to, well, probably not understand, but see it. Il marche tout seul sans que je ne l'aide. Il marche tout seul sans que je ne l'aide. He walks alone without me helping him. Or, prépare le dossier avant que je n'arrive. Prépare le dossier avant que je n'arrive. Get the file ready before I arrive. So here, a little note about this. I don't expect anyone who is learning French to use this correctly or use this even at all. I think it's just good to know because ne is a part of the negation, and if you see this in a book, you're going to be very confused over why there's no second part of the negation, why is that a negative type when technically the sentence is a positive sentence, affirmative sentence. This is just good to know that it's not a negative, it's just good to know to understand it, okay? So don't worry about using it, just make sure you know what it is. But if you want to practice, you can do the exercise 11.14. Last point for the subjonctif we have after the superlative. I know that some people already have trouble with the superlative. We are going to see the superlative more in detail on the grammar course, but now it's also used in subjonctif. So if we have le seul, la seule, qui, que, dont. Translate to the only one, that, in English. C'est le seul qui sache faire fonctionner cette machine. C'est le seul qui sache faire fonctionner cette machine. The next one. Le premier, la première, qui, que. The first one, that. La première qui arrive gagne le gros lot. La première qui arrive gagne le gros lot. Le meilleur, la meilleure, qui, que. The best one, that. C'est la meilleure tarte que j'ai jamais mangée. C'est la meilleure tarte que j'ai jamais mangée. It's the best pie that I ever ate. Il n'y a que. Qui que. There's only that. Il n'y a que l'argent qui compte pour toi. Il n'y a que l'argent qui compte pour toi. There's only money for you. And the last one. Il y a peu de qui que. Il y a peu d'oisions qui survivent le premier mois. Il y a peu d'oisions qui survivent le premier mois. There aren't many chicks that survive the first month. The last exercise for the subjonctif is 11.15. I really hope you enjoyed the lesson. Tomorrow we are going to see the plus que parfait. Thanks again to Lingoda for sponsoring this video. I will see you tomorrow. À demain.